having been in Finland now for a few days and having the privilege of going to the Finnish Sauna Society and also hanging out with some other friends here in Finland, I've had a chance to experience the sauna culture, the traditional sauna, smoke saunas, and also the other, you know, dry saunas and the Loulou. But what I also noticed is that almost 100% of the Finnish people that I that use the sauna, after the sauna, like to go run into and jump into a cold lake or the Baltic or something cold, very, very cold. And they do this, you know, several times. I mean, this is, it seems to be a very normal part of Finnish sauna culture.
Yeah.
Is that accurate, you would say?
Yeah. Many people are using it. I know it.
So I have a question on whether, you know, what is the safety, you know, is there any safety issues? Because I've read a couple of case reports where because you're going from hot sauna where vasodilation's occurring and then you're going into cold where vasoconstriction's occurring, norepinephrine's being released and vasoconstriction's occurring, there have been a couple of documented cases of like coronary artery spasm, I think it's called. Maybe do you think there's a potential risk of going from hot to cold in terms of people with maybe a pre-existing heart disease or something?
Yeah, among those patients who have coronary heart disease, and especially if it's not a stable condition, then you have to be very careful. You cannot do that because there can be a spasm in coronary arteries and it can be harmful,
But for the most people, part of the population, it seems to be pretty safe. I mean, I've done it before and it feels really good. I mean, you feel amazing after doing the hot and cold. Also interested in if it blunts any of the positive effects. But what's interesting is I've seen that cold also activates heat shock proteins, because heat shock proteins are part of the stress response. You know, it's sort of, it's called hormetic stress. Are you familiar with hormesis? It's like a little bit of good stress where it's not too much stress, but it's enough stress to activate all these genetic pathways that help you deal with stress. Well, heat shock proteins are one of those genetic pathways. Yeah. And so cold is also a little bit of a hormetic stress, like, and exercise activates heat shock proteins as well. And then, but heat robustly activates them, very robustly. So the cold shock, it's good to know that both the hot and the cold are activating some of the same good genetic pathways, so maybe you're not negating all the good stuff you just did with the sauna, right? Maybe there's synergy.
We would be really happy to investigate those possible mechanisms between sauna and memory disease.
Absolutely.
Because we have been thinking through, you know, more like improved cardiovascular system and circulation and these, if they have an effect on the memory diseases, because some cardiovascular diseases and memory diseases are sharing the bit similar risk factors and so
like vascular dementia, of course, blood flow is absolutely linked to dementia, so it's probably there's probably multiple mechanisms by which the sauna man, it's just, it's great, we gotta get the word out there, you know, more research, more people using the sauna. I think that's
because I think that there are nowadays there are so many studies showing to positive effects of physical exercise on these outcomes and vessel function and so on, but there are quite limited data on sauna use and warm exposure and these similar outcomes. So there are space to do these kind of research.
Yeah, you're like you know, an explorer in new territory.
Yeah,
no one's really doing this, you know, and it's really great. I'm very glad that someone is, you know. So please keep up the good work.
Yeah, and in the best case, of course, we can combine these positive effects in like exercise and sauna.
Are you going to look at that as well? Are you going to see if there's a synergy?
Yeah, we try to do something. Yeah, with what is also important for public health level. That also we have to emphasize that there are many other factors in addition to exercise and sauna. There are other also, of course, we have to take care of other risk factors like blood pressure, lipids, smoking, obesity in addition to that.
Yeah.